Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. In previous modules, we have learnt about ecosystem, different types of ecosystems and the structures and functions of ecosystems. In this module, we shall be studying about desert ecosystem in detail. The learning objectives of this module are controlling factors forming deserts, the distribution and climate of deserts, adaptation of plants and animals to dry conditions, biodiversity and community composition, desert ecosystem functions, and finally, we will study about human impacts on desert ecosystems. Mostly, deserts occur in 25 to 35 degree north and south of the equator. Deserts are arid and hyper arid areas where less than 250 mm of rainfalls in a year, resulting in low soil water availability, sparse growth of vegetation and low productivity. Evaporation exceeds rainfall in desert ecosystems. Temperature is extremely variable. The Sahara in Africa is hot all year round, but Asia's Gobi Desert is quite cold in winter. It is interesting that deserts are having high biodiversity in spite of their low productivity. The world's deserts occupy almost 17% of the Earth's land surface. The deserts and desert margins are home to about 8% of the global human population. Some of the poorest and most marginalized people in the world live in deserts. The poor people depend on deserts for sustainable ecosystem services under changing climate. Controlling factors forming deserts. There are several factors which control forming of deserts, and these factors are Earth's air circulation pattern, rain shadow effect, distance from the ocean, and near cold ocean currents. Let me discuss them one by one in detail. Earth's air circulation pattern. Subtropical deserts are caused by the circulation pattern of air masses. They are found along the Tropic of Cancer between 15 and 30 degree north of the equator, or along the Tropic of Capricorn between 15 and 30 degrees south of the equator. Warm air rises at the equator and cools. Since cool air holds less water, precipitation is common at the equator. The dry air mass moves north and south to 30 degrees north and 30 degrees south. At plus minus 30 degrees, the dry air sinks and warms. The warmer air can hold more water, resulting in evaporation of water and the formation of deserts. The Sahara Desert, that is in North America, and the Kalahari Desert, that is in South Africa, are formed as a result of low pressure air heating the ground and evaporating ground water. The second factor was rain shadow effect. Hot rising air cools as it approaches a mountain. Less water can be held and windward side of the mountain get rain. The cooler air that crosses over mountains is dry. So, deserts form on the leeward side of the mountain range. Leeward slopes face away from prevailing wind. Some examples of rain shadow effect deserts are the Gobi Desert north of the Himalayas. Major rain shadow effects occur in Atacama Desert, Chile, caused by the Andes Mountain. Third factor was distance from the ocean. Interior deserts, which are found in the heart of continents, exist because no moisture-laden winds reach them. The Gobi Desert in China and Mongolia lies hundreds of kilometers from the ocean. Winds that reach the Gobi lose their moisture. And fourth factor was near cold ocean current. Cold ocean currents contribute to the formation of coastal deserts. A coastal desert may be almost totally rainless, yet damp with fog. The Atacama Desert on the Pacific shores of Chile is a coastal desert. The main characteristics of deserts. First one, humidity. Humidity, you know, is the water vapors that are present in the air. So humidity is near zero in most of the deserts. Light rains often evaporate in the dry air, never reaching the ground. Second is temperature extremes. Annual precipitation less than the potential evaporative demand, low soil moisture availability to support primary productivity, winds at speed of about 100 kilometers per hour in some deserts. Rain is usually the main source of water in a desert. Many desert dwellers rely on groundwater stored in aquifers below the surface. The distribution of desert ecosystems. Aridity index. In the aridity index is the ratio between mean annual precipitation and mean annual potential evapotranspiration. Arid and hyperarid regions have a P upon PET ratio of less than 0.20. Rainfall supplies less than 20% of the amount of water needed to support optimum plant growth. Based on this criteria, aridity is highest in the Saharan and Chilean Peruvian deserts, followed by Arabian, East African, Gobi, Australian and South African deserts, and it is generally lower in the Thar and North American deserts. This figure shows that the hyperarid and arid regions cover about 17% of the Earth's land and 45% of land excluding Antarctica area is considered dry land. This table shows deserts and areas of hyperarid and arid regions of the world classification. So, as we have discussed earlier, areas can be classified as hyperarid and arid. In case of hyperarid, aridity index is less than 0.05, and in case of arid, the aridity index is 0.05 to 0.20, whereas about 6.6% area of the world comes under hyperarid deserts and about 10.6% area of the world comes under arid deserts. Let me see different deserts that are present in the northern hemisphere. In Northern America, the major deserts are the Mojave, Sonoran and Chihuahuan deserts. In Northern Africa, the Sahara Desert forms an immense swathe. Here the swathe means a long mass of land, a long strip of land. Then in the Horn of Africa, the Somali, Ethiopian deserts, whereas in Asia, the Arabian, Mesopotamian, Persian, Thar Desert that stretch from West Asia into Pakistan and India, the Central Asian deserts in Uzbekistan, Turkmenistan and the Taklimakan Then Gobi Desert in China and Mongolia. The Sahara Desert forms an immense swath in northern Africa, including Algeria, Chad, Egypt, Libya, Mali, Mauritania, Morocco, Niger, Sudan, Tunisia. The Sahara Desert extends over 9 million square kilometers and it covers about 25% of the African continent. Outside of the polar areas, the largest is the Sahara Desert, a subtropical desert. Here this map shows different countries in which Sahara Desert extends. The Gobi in China and Mongolia is a cold desert. Frost and occasionally snow occur on the dunes of Gobi Desert. Rainfall is approximately 194 mm annually in the Gobi Desert. The climate of the Gobi is one of great extremes. Combined with rapid changes of temperature, could be 35 degrees Celsius. These can occur not only seasonally but within 24 hours. This map shows the areas to which Gobi Desert extends. The Thar Desert in northwestern India. It is a unique and the only habitat of its type in the Indian subcontinent. The Aravalli Hills mark the easternmost boundary limit of the Thar Desert, while the western limit is defined by the fertile plains of the Indus. The Great Run of Kutch in the Kutch district of Gujarat state forms a sharp boundary in the south. The annual rainfall in the desert is generally low, ranging from about 100 millimeter or less in the west to about 500 millimeter in the east. So, we have discussed the deserts of northern hemisphere. Now, let we have a look on the deserts of southern hemisphere. The Atacama, Puna and Monte deserts in South America, the Namib and the Karoo in Southern Africa, the vast expanse of Australian deserts. The Namib is a cool coastal desert in Southern Africa. Moisture derived from underground water sources sustains one of the world's oldest and most biologically diverse deserts. Fog is the primary source of water, accounting for a unique environment in which endemic invertebrates, reptiles, and mammals adapt to a variety of microhabitats and ecological niches. There is an extraordinary diversity of succulent plants as well as the shrub-like plant. Welwitschia mirabilis, which has only two leaves seen above ground and can live for over 1000 years. This figure shows the climate graph for the hot desert, that is Sahara Desert. Temperature in Sahara Desert, hot conditions dominate, though often seasonal. As far as precipitation is concerned, very little precipitation, but with long dry periods. All hot deserts characterized by prolonged extreme soil drought. Cold desert climate, temperature, extreme fluctuation from hot summers to cold winters, precipitation, low and reasonably consistent, growing season, short and hot. Soils of the desert ecosystem. Aridisol soil profile showing a low humus surface layer at the top of a clay layer and a calcium carbonate horizons. Soils of the Thar Desert. The soils consist of several main groups. Desert soils, red desertic soils, xerogems are brownish gray soils, the red and yellow soils of the foothills, the saline soils of the depressions, and the lithosols, that is shallow weathered soils, and rhizosols, that is soft loose soils found in the hills. All those soils are coarse textured, well drained and calcareous. A thick accumulation of lime often occurs at varying depth. The soils are generally infertile and suffer from severe wind erosion. Plants and animals have many adaptations to dry conditions. The examples are spines, succulents, thick waxy cuticle, shallow broad roots. Cacti are well adapted for survival in the deserts, and cacti have stems that can store water, widespread root systems that can collect water from a large area. Cacti have spines instead of leaves. Here a picture of a cactus is shown. This slide shows some beautiful desert plants, and these are different species of cacti. First one is Opuntia, second one is Pachypodium, and these pictures have been taken from the Sarkaria Cactus Garden, Panchkula, Haryana. Then lithops. Lithops are stone plants. Succulents found in the South African and Namibian deserts are specially adapted to conserve water, including the ability to recycle their own moisture and nutrient. This figure shows stone plants. These plants are very, very interesting, and when these plants are present along with stones, it's really difficult to identify these plants. This picture is taken from the Plante Paradise, that is in Himachal Pradesh, India. Like plants, desert animals also have several adaptations. Let me discuss them one by one. First one is drought escapers. Some animals escape the heat in cool burrows. The fennec fox, for example, is native to the Sahara Desert. Drought evaders. Drought evading animals go into estivation, you know what is estivation, or some other dormant stage during the dry season. Then third is drought resistors. Animals that have adapted to a desert environment are called as gyrocoles. Drought endurers, they use their tail like a parasol. The African ground squirrel found in the Namib desert protect itself from the sun. Let me discuss about fennec fox. Fennec fox, native to the Sahara Desert, live in sandy Sahara and elsewhere in North Africa. Nocturnal habits help them deal with the high heat of the desert environment. Their distinctive bat-like ears radiate body heat and help keep the foxes cool. They also have long, thick hair that insulates them during cold nights and protects them from hot sun during the day. The fox feet are hairy, which protects them from extreme hot scent. Let me take another example, the camel. Camels live in deserts that are hot and dry during the day but cold at night. There are several adaptations in the camels. Let me see what are the adaptations in the camel. First one is large flat feet to spread their weight on the sand. Second is thick fur on the top of the body. Third is a large surface area to volume ratio to maximize heat loss. Fourth is the ability to go for a long time without water. And fifth is slit-like nostrils and two rows of long eyelashes to help keep the scent out. Bacterian camel of Gobi Desert. Let me see this animal. We know that Gobi Desert is a cold desert, one of the most hostile and fragile regions of the planet. This Bactrian camel is adapted to life in the harsh Gobi Desert. The species can withstand drought, food shortage, and even radiation from nuclear weapons testing. This animal is classified as critically endangered, but continue to be threatened by hunting, habitat loss, and introduced livestock. Biodiversity and community composition. The deserts contain rich biodiversity and exhibit unique natural adaptations of plants and animals. The reptiles, including snakes, tortoises, and lizards, are one of the more familiar species groups associated with deserts, contain some of the most endangered species of plants and animals in the world. Deserts and other dryland ecosystems have almost one third of the terrestrial global carbon stock. Desert genetic biodiversity is key to improving dryland agricultural productivity. Let me see the Sonoran Desert that is in the southwestern North America. The Sonoran Desert receives more rainfall than any other desert, about 250 to 350 mm rainfall per year. This Sonoran Desert has most complex desert vegetation. The keystone species of the Sonoran Desert is the saguaro cactus, which grows very tall with giant spiny green arms reaching upward. Here in this picture, this saguaro cactus is shown. This grows very slowly and may live up to 200 years. This giant saguaro cacti provide nests for desert birds. Let me have a look on the Namib Desert, that is a cool coastal desert in the southern Africa. A large number of endemic plants and animals occur in this desert ecosystem. Fog is the primary source of water in the site. A shrub-like plant, Welwitschia mirabilis, which has only two leaves seen above ground and can live for over 1000 years. This plant provides moisture and nutrients for desert mammals, shelter for snakes, lizards, and arthropods, and is an attraction for ecotourists. A number of animals occur, including the mountain zebra, James buck, and Karoo bustard. Biodiversity. The Thar Desert sand dunes form 58% of the Thar Desert. Stabilized dunes are covered mainly by Caparis decidua, Calotropis procera, Caligonum polygonides, Acacia senegal, Prosopis cineraria, Erva javanica, Aristida species, and other semophytic species. In saline depression, there is a halophytic vegetation. The Thar Desert, though one of the smallest deserts in the world, it harbors a wide array of flora and fauna species. The Rajasthan state bird, you know, the great Indian bustard, state animal, chinkara, and state tree, that is khesdi, and state flower, rohida, are found naturally in the Thar Desert. The desert vegetation is mostly herbaceous or stunted scrub. Drought-resistant trees sparsely dot the landscape, especially in the east region. On the hills, gum arabic acacia and euphorbia may be found. The khesri tree is shown here in this picture. The scientific name of this tree is Prosopis cineraria, grows throughout the plains. fixes large amount of nitrogen and maintain soil fertility. This tree, Khejri tree, is favored for agroforestry as it fixes large amounts of nitrogen and doesn't affect growth of plants under the canopy. Or in other words, we can say that Khejri plant is not having allelopathy effect on the other plants growing in its vicinity. Some other examples of the desert plants are shown in this picture, and examples are Tecomella, Caparis, Calotropis, Erva. Most of the vegetation that grow in the deserts consist of stunted, thorny and prickly shrubs and perennial herbs which are resistant to drought. So we have discussed different type of desert ecosystem all around the world. Now let me discuss desert ecosystem functions. The desert ecosystem functions, we will be discussing mainly net primary productivity, food webs and nutrient cycling. First, let me take net primary productivity. The annual above ground net primary productivity production varies from 30 to 300 gram dry weight per meter square per year in arid zones. The lowest observed production that is 2.6 gram dry weight per square meter per year reported for a dune community during a dry year. The average production over a 4-year period was 180 and 137 gram dry weight per square meter per year. The largest year-to-year variation in above ground production occurs for annual species in the Mojave and Sonoran deserts. The second function is food web. Food chains are long with the several predation links up to the top, in spite of the desert's overall low primary productivity. The grazing food chain and the detritus food chain parallel one another. The energy ultimately consumed by the higher trophic level organisms being derived principally from the detritus. The another parameter is nitrogen cycling in a desert ecosystem. The nitrogen cycle relies on bacteria that make nitrogen useful to organisms and bacteria that can return it to the atmosphere. The atmosphere, you know that nitrogen is present in gaseous form in atmosphere, goes through the fixation of lightning and the fixation by the organisms into the soil organic matter. Symbiotic fixation by leguminous and other naturally occurring plants may be significant in some warm desert communities. Nitrogen fixation by soil algae and bacteria probably provides a major input of nitrogen in most desert ecosystems. Nitrogen return via litter and deep plants is localized around the plants and dead plants localized around the plants. In the soil, the organic matter is converted by soil microorganisms to ammonia. This flow chart shows the nitrogen cycling in a desert ecosystem as we have discussed just now. This shows that how atmospheric nitrogen is fixed by the lightning and microorganism, and then how it is converted to ammonium by the microorganism and going to the plants, and then from plants going to the consumer, and then it is going to the detritus, these decomposers, and finally again released in as atmospheric nitrogen. This flow chart shows the human impact on desert ecosystem. Humans have badly affected the desert ecosystems. Main anthropogenic factors that impact the desert ecosystems include overgrazing and expansion of cropped area, reduction in vegetative cover, increased soil erosion, large scale expansion of agriculture, Stalinization, climate change and drought. These are the some factors which have impacted the desert ecosystems. Now, to summarize this module, deserts are arid and hyper-arid lands where less than 250 mm of rainfall in a year is received. The Sahara of North Africa is the largest desert in the world. The deserts, in spite of their low productivity, have high biodiversity, diverse life forms and adaptations. The Thar desert in India sports rich biodiversity. In the highly stressful desert environment, net primary productivity is generally very low, variable over time and space. Complex feeding and predator-prey relationship. Food chains are long with several predation links up to the top. In arid regions, nutrient levels may limit plant productivity besides moisture availability. Nitrogen appears to be the key limiting nutrient in most hot deserts. The various human impacts include overgrazing and expansion of agriculture, increased soil erosion and climate change. Thank you.